Jumping from a plane without a parachute may seem like a recipe for certain death, but could aiming for a water landing somehow improve your slim odds of surviving a fall from thousands of feet up? Let's look at the physics involved. First off, don't try this. Jumping from a plane without a chute should only ever be a last resort if you have no other means of escaping a doomed airplane. Though still extremely dangerous, a water landing gives you the best shot at living through this literal plunge into the unknown. Before exiting the plane, look for any large objects to ride on the way down. Debris like catering carts or tail sections could partially absorb the inevitable impact forces. In 1972, a flight attendant named Vesna Vulevic survived a 33,000-foot fall while wedged between wreckage, earning her an incredible world record. You'll rapidly accelerate to terminal velocity, around 120 miles per hour. That's the maximum speed you will reach while free-falling, with your body facing belly down. Other positions are slightly faster. The surface tension of water makes hitting it at such high speeds similar to slamming into concrete. To minimize the massive impact, aim your body feet or head first when approaching the water. This presents a smaller cross-section of impact, like a knife's edge, rather than your full width smashing into the surface of the water. However, this maneuver could boost your terminal velocity from the added streamlining. When you pierce the surface, rapid deceleration will probably exceed 100 Gs. Race car drivers have briefly survived over 200 Gs, but water's density would likely far surpass the human limit of a few hundred Gs. Massive internal hemorrhaging and organ damage from the shock are unavoidable. These crushing forces upon your body make impacts from great heights almost always fatal. Surviving such extensive internal injuries is unlikely. Theoretically, you want to penetrate just deep enough to slow gradually before bobbing back up for air. However, that perfect trajectory is nearly impossible to achieve when hurtling down in an uncontrolled manner. Overshooting puts you at the ocean floor's mercy. In reality, jumping without a parachute, even into water, almost always guarantees a fatal outcome. The margin for error is minuscule and conditions are unpredictable. Your focus should be on steering toward the water rather than mere survival. The closest verified case is a skydiver whose chute failed. He steered into a dark, snow-covered forest and managed to live despite hitting the trees. Even with today's technology, an unprotected fall from extreme altitudes almost always ends tragically. Rather than gambling on a one-in-a-million miracle, do all you can to prevent ever needing to jump without a parachute. But in a life-or-death scenario, a water landing gives you and perhaps your loved ones a sliver of hope for defying the odds. Focus on that glimmer as you take the ultimate leap of faith. Popular culture often depicts heroes surviving impossible falls based on luck or skill, but reality is less forgiving of such extreme gambles with mortality. Those contemplating reckless jumps should understand the grave unlikelihood of cheating death. Base jumpers with parachutes still perish at alarming rates, even with proper training and equipment. Accidents happen, gear fails, variables align against you, and jumping without means of deceleration leaves absolutely no room for error. Perhaps one day, advanced technology like anti-gravity fields could reliably protect freefallers, but for now, grasp at whatever shred of hope keeps you motivated during such an unthinkable descent. Avoid the temptation of fantasies. Keep a sober view of the low odds, make peace with your fear, and steer towards that glimmer on the horizon as the ultimate test of courage. We all hope that death comes on our own terms when we're good and ready, but should fate demand an early jump, may your spirit stay strong as you plummet into the unknown. If we must go into that endless sky, let us savor the rush of wind we were blessed to feel, however brief and final it may be.